joining us on another edition of 15 on 15 right here on Channel 15 ATV with Danielle Piazzi. Let's get started with our latest local news topics. As we are quickly moving through the first month of 2016, businesses all over the island are planning their strategies and projects for the year ahead. This is no different for the Aruba Tourism Authority, who is planning to make 2016 a record-breaking year. Here's how.
It has officially been 5 years since the Aruba Tourism Authority began caring for Aruba's largest economic pillar as an independent entity rather than a part of the government. Over the past several years, this organization has brought Aruba's name at high standards internationally and has promoted the country as a whole worldwide. Big recognitions and projects that we can admire from just the past year are the Happiness Builder for First. The introduction of this program played a big factor in Aruba winning the strongest digital marketing in the Caribbean. Another unforgettable recognition the island received was the World Legacy Award by National Geographic for its green initiatives and visionary plans for 2020. Also, at the World Travel Market in England, Aruba received the silver medal for responsible tourism destination in the world. Besides these awards, this year was the first time the Aruba Restaurant Week took place. Its goal was to promote local restaurants and dishes in the lower season by offering special promotions for lunch and dinner menus. Lastly, in the summer of this year, the Duna Aruba Lo Mejor Dibo campaign was launched to motivate those who work in the tourism sector to always be hospitable towards the island's visitors. For 2016, the Aruba Tourism Authority will be refocusing on a traditional slogan, namely, Un Aruba Dushi Pabiba Ta Un Aruba Dushi Pabishita, which literally translates to, an Aruba that is nice to live on is an Aruba that is nice to visit. Each year, the Aruba Tourism Authority sets ambitious goals, and time again, we have been proved that they are mature and developed enough to reach them. Projections for 2016 include an increase of 5.5% in total visitors by plane, a 6% growth in tourism receipts, and a 9% augmentation in RevPAR between 2014 and 2017. Aruba is the country with the highest tourism dependency worldwide, with it contributing to 88% of Aruba's GDP. Therefore, to remain a strong market, plans are in place to begin market diversification in regions of Mexico and South Florida, which have proven to be beneficial to the island. 76% of ATA's budget will purely be invested in the marketing of Aruba as a product.
At the end of 2015, the Aruba Tourism Authority was presented with a new challenge. With Pulmantur rerouting 18 of their ships, the island will no longer be surpassing their 2013 record of nearly 700,000 cruise visitors. Therefore, ATA, together with the Tourism Ministry, are looking into a new plan of action, namely introducing new cruise routes to the Aruban ports.
Late last year, the Aruba Tourism Authority was informed that the Pulmantur Cruise Lines would be rerouting several of their ships due to suffering economies in the Latin American region.
Pulmantur made a decision based on the fact that the economies, various economies in Latin America are suffering, namely Brazil, which was a key market for them for their services within the Caribbean region, also the Colombian market. Mainly because of that, they decided to go back to what is their strength and their strong market, which is Spain and the Mediterranean region, basically. So they are allocating a total of 18 ships next year, taking them out of the Caribbean and deploying them, basically, in these specific regions.
Therefore, although 2016 will not surpass the 2013 record, it is still expected to be a strong year.
We are in close contact with Royal Caribbean Cruise Lines, the mother company of Pulmantur, and there are some interesting developments in partnership with Panama, considering the developments in respect to Panama Canal and the desire of Panama to also grow cruise tourism. Also, we are in contact also with Curacao and Colombia. So there, we are joining efforts in not targeting necessarily Pulmantur, which might be a bit more sensitive in respect to economies and changes on that front. But we are combining forces to attract RCCL ships, and we hope to have this crystallized. At least by the end of 2016, that would be a great accomplishment.
Tune back in tomorrow to find out what investments ATA will be making this upcoming year and also what are the greatest issues this organization faces ahead. We'll be back with more 15 on 15 English news after a quick commercial break.
When we come back, this record-breaking lottery has three winners.